here with Mike Mendoza. Mike, and lots to talk about in this episode. And we'll start off with the cycle lanes. You were there with my colleague, other colleague, Olivia Marshall, covering the cycle lane protest. It's heated, isn't it? And it's very divisive, isn't it? One of the most divisive issues, I would say, in regards to a local issue in recent times.
Well, I mean, it's very awkward. I mean, when we got there at the protest on Friday at Hove Town Hall, there was probably about 30, 40 people there. When it finished, it was well over 100 people there.
Yeah.
It started off very, very well. There was a sound system there. The guy who organised it, I think his name's Chris, was telling everybody his thoughts, and a lot of people were cheering and clapping. And then suddenly, the town hall, someone from the town hall came out and disconnected the sound system and threatened the cafe owner that they would actually be thrown out of the cafe, they'd lose their lease if they continued to supply the electricity for the sound system, which is absolutely appalling. And so suddenly, that got everyone really riled up. So, you know, is democracy dead in Brighton and Hove? I don't know. Are they going to stop people talking out and making a protest? There's, of course, another protest on the Sunday, next Sunday, which I'm sure there'll be several thousand people at. I think it's going to be a very big one because there's been a lot of publicity for this.
Yeah, and from the Greens' perspective, they've kind of laid out their, you know, their reasoning behind the cycle lanes. I've spoken to both Councillor Sue Shanks, Deputy Leader. I've spoken to the other Deputy Leader, of course, Hannah Clare, as well as Tom Drewitt. And so they're saying that, you know, this is a government-led initiative. You know, they have a certain time frame in order to implement the cycle lanes, and that at the moment they're temporary. I mean, Tom Drewitt was at pains to say that on multiple occasions to me when I spoke to him.
Yeah.
What's your feelings?
They would, wouldn't they? If you listen to Pete West's statement from 2 years ago, 2 years ago Pete West said he would like to see cycle lanes going either side of the 259, the coast road, and just one single lane either way of traffic. Now, doesn't it not seem strange to you the government come out in July and say that you can put cycle lanes in? Within 48 hours, those cycle lanes were in. It must take more than 48 hours normally to organise this. So, therefore, it's been on the planning table, I think, for a long, long time.
Yeah, OK. We'll leave it there. Mike, thanks for coming in today, and we'll catch up again soon. Cheers, thanks.